Welcome to WebStylePress. If you are new here, consider subscribing and hit bell icon. Git is easy. Learn few commands that you will be using repetitively. Have a look. Use terminal to use these commands. I often use Git Bash. Here are these commands: Git Init, Git Clone, Git Add, Git Commit, Git Push and Pull, and Git Branch, Git Checkout, and Git Stash, and Git Status. And then we have got flags for these commands like Git Commit, Dash M, and Message. And for Git Push, you can see Git Push Origin and Branch Name, Git Pull Origin, Branch Name, and Git Branch, New Branch Name, Git Clone, and then repo link or repository link. So Git Init, it creates a new Git repository or initialize a new empty repository in the root directory of the project. Git Clone, copy repo link and use this command to clone that repo in BC or clone repo locally. Git Add, it adds a change in the working directory to the staging area. It tells Git that you want to include updates to a particular file in the next commit. You have to use this command before you commit changes. Usually I use this Git Add with a period. After you change your files, you should run this command Git Add period, and all of the changes that you have done in files will be included in next commit. After the changes, this is the first command that you run. Then we have got Git Commit. The full syntax is this: Git Commit dash M and then Message. It saves your changes to the local repo. You have to use this command before you push changes to repo and after Git Add. Make sure you have run Git Add period command, then you will use Git Commit dash M and then Message. It will save your changes to local repo. Then we have got Git Push. It uploads your changes from local repo to remote repo. Full command is this: Git Push Origin and then Branch Name. So Git Push Origin, this is the branch name that will receive changes. You are pushing to this branch. Then Git Pull. Actual command is like this: Git Pull Origin and then branch name. In case you want to pull latest changes from remote repo to current working local repo, use this command. It is used to sync data. Git Branch. So a Git repository or Git repo has got branches. Git repository or Git repo has got a master branch and then it has got branches. Git Branch command lets you list branches for the current repo that you are working with. Also, you can create a new branch with this command, like Git Branch New Branch Name. This will create a new branch for current repo. Git Checkout Branch Name. It is used to exit current branch and switch to branch name mentioned here. You can also use Git Checkout dash B and then branch name. This command will create a new branch with this name and will switch to it. Git Stash. It temporarily shelves or postpones changes you have made to your working copy so you can work on something else and then come back and reapply these changes later on. Git Status. It is used to see status of current branch, whether we need to commit and push changes or not. So generally these are the commands that are used with the Git. Further, actually you will be using these commands like these. So learn these commands, remember these commands, you only need to remember and learn these commands. Like, first of all, you clone a repository. This is the repository link from GitHub, and ignore these brackets, git clone repo link, and remote directory will be copied in your PC. And then you will make changes to that repo or files in that repo, and then you will use this command, git add period. And after that, you will use git commit dash m, and here will be the message about the changes that you have done to that repo or files in that repo. And after that, you will use git push origin, and you will mention the branch name. Then those changes, those files, those new files or changed files will be pushed to that branch name that you are working with. And this is git pull origin command that you can use to pull latest changes from GitHub. If you want to create a new branch, use this command git branch and use branch name here. And if you want to switch branch, let's say you have created a branch, you have worked within that branch, and now you want to switch to another branch, you want to work in another branch, then you will use this git checkout and then branch name, and you will be switched to that branch. And if you want to create a new branch and also switch to that branch, you will use this command git checkout dash b and branch name. This branch with this name will be created and you will be switched to that branch. Then you will be working in that branch. So these are the important commands that I tend to use again and again repetitively. And if you learn to use these, Git is easy for you. Alright, that's it for this video. I will create a detailed tutorial on these commands, so stay tuned. I hope you like this video. If I missed anything, comment down below. If you haven't already subscribed, subscribe to this channel and hit bell icon to receive updates. Join us on social media. Links are in the description below. Stay tuned for more updates. I will see you in the next video.